you little monsters, this little monster girl Desi coming at ya. And today, I finally have a story time for you guys. Originally, I wanted to do a Mother's Day story time about my mom, but with life kind of going on around me, I wasn't able to have any quiet time to actually record. And because it takes a while to both record and then edit the audio and then put everything together, I wasn't sure if I would be able to get one in time because I wasn't sure when I'd have any quiet time. But you guys definitely seem to have enjoyed the Mother's Day video I made. So, win-win, I guess. And before we get started, I would like to say that my commissions are currently open. And as you can see from this opening, I didn't try to put together a little animation, like I usually do, and I know you guys enjoy that part. But because this little story time was thrown together because of something that happened a few days ago, I couldn't think of anything to actually illustrate. And plus, I had a lot of people commission me. Well, I mean a lot more than usual. And thought it would be a good idea to just use the speed paints from those and just put them together for this. So if you guys want to help support me, my commission sheets are both on my Tumblr and my Instagram currently, and links to both in the description. Also, for more of life stuff info, watch till the end of the video. So with that said, let's get started. Today I'm just going to talk about a few what the fuck moments that I've had. I don't know if any of these are very funny, but I thought you guys might get a kick out of them. Especially since I haven't been able to write up a script for, well, anything else. But anyways, the very first what the fuck moment that comes to mind is the time I got sleep drunk at the fair. Now, this happened last summer when I actually started posting these story times on my channel. I think maybe my very first video where I was actually talking was posted before I started my job at the fair. And I actually wanted to do a video on what happened during that time, but never got around to it because of a bunch of other stuff that was going on. And because that's all in a video itself, I'll just give you a small story of what happened. Now, this happened on the very last day of the fair. It was late, and I guess everybody was getting a little bit tired. My job was relatively easy, since I was just making scones at a sweet stand. But then suddenly, I got what I can only describe as being tipsy. Now, those of you who don't know, I'm currently 22 years old. But I don't smoke, and I don't drink. In fact, the only thing that has ever come close to being alcohol is root beer, which was actually an alcoholic beverage at one point, but that's not the main focus of this. Basically, what was going on around me seemed like it was something to laugh at. Luckily, I wasn't laughing like a lunatic, but I was still acting a little bit goofy. And yet, still, I was managed to do the very simple job of making scones. Since it was nearing the end of the shift, all I had to do was finish up what was already there, and then I could probably get off. The one thing I do remember happening is that once things were calming down even more, I decided to sweep up a little bit because cutting open the scone so we could add the filling always created a bunch of crumbs. And you want to guess what I did? Now I bet you can't guess. I started lightly singing the Sweep Sweep song from My Little Pony. You know that one episode where Rarity's friends were helping her with her new boutique? Yep. I was singing that song that Twilight was singing as I was sweeping. I wish I was kidding. But nope. Some of the co-workers that had been working at the scone stand with me were, like, softly giggling. Because I was just acting a little bit weird. Now, the odd thing was is that I was fully conscious of everything that was going on, yet at the same time, I couldn't really control it. I don't know if that's how people are when they're lightly drunk, but that's definitely how I was while I was sleep drunk. One coworker who was actually younger than me asked if I was alright while lightly giggling, and when she asked me that, that's when I suddenly realized I was on the ground. Now, I hadn't fallen down like I had tripped on anything. I guess I just kind of like, lightly fell down on my butt. And I just looked at her and smiled, while giggling, saying, "Whoops." Now, this didn't happen just once. It actually happened a second time nearing the very, very end of my shift. And when it happened the second time, I decided, huh, this is probably a good moment to clock out. And so I wrote on the whole schedule thing that I was clocking out. I said goodbye and I grabbed a few scones from the warming thing, because my mom actually really liked the scones from that stand. And I booked it. Because at that point I realized, oh my frickin' god, I am frickin' sleep drunk. Oddly enough though, when I told my mom that I had fallen down twice at work, she didn't really laugh. And if you watched one of my earlier videos where I had actually fallen down while at Winco, you'd know the story that she was referencing to when she said, huh, that better not have been like what happened at Winco. And I honestly would have felt better if she had just giggled it off and then took him home. Now the second what the F story that comes to mind is the time that I got flirted with while at the library with my grandma Margaret. A bit of context. Me and my grandma Margaret used to go to the library together anytime that I would go and visit my dad. The two of us would catch a bus down to the public library and just quietly hang out together. We did that a lot, and I actually slept in her room whenever I slept over at my dad's house. So this was just a quiet moment for us to bond together. I always really enjoyed it, and I especially loved how quiet it always was at the library. Being as that I have ADHD and autism, I don't like loud places very much. At this point I can deal with them, but I still am extremely socially awkward. So you can only imagine how awkward I was feeling when a guy suddenly started flirting with me. It was at the end of our library trip and my grandma was checking out books. And like always, I was waiting at the entrance for her while sitting on one of the benches. As I was scrolling through my phone, I noticed a guy around my age hanging up posters. I didn't really see what they were, so I just went back to scrolling on my phone. And then suddenly, the guy turned around and started talking to me. And not just talking to me, but flirting with me while also, I guess, campaigning for a no smoking thing. I'm not completely sure. This happened a while ago, so I can't completely remember all that he was saying. But I do remember that his opening line was, hey, you have really pretty lips. And me being the socially awkward, antisocial monster that I am, just said, thank you? And hoping that would be the end of it, started scrolling through my phone again. Mostly to make it look like I did not want to talk, which I did not. But he persisted. He started going on and on about how smoking would ruin such pretty lips, and that it was really, really bad for me. Even though I highly doubt I gave any indication that I was a smoker of any kind. Because as I stated before, I have never smoked, nor have I ever drank alcohol. So this was completely out of the blue for me. I've been complimented on my drawings while drawing on the bus, but I've never been flirted with while also being given a pitch for a whole no smoking thing. And this conversation seemed to drag on for hours, especially since it was very one-sided and he just kept talking to me. Obviously not getting the hint that I wanted him to go away. When he finally left was when my grandma was coming through the door, saying that she was all ready to go, and I instantly got up, fully ready to get the frick out of there, because I had no idea what the fuck just happened. Luckily, the guy didn't try to continue, he just walked away. And as he did, I realized what he had been putting up. It was a poster for a whole obviously not smoking campaign and how cigarettes were bad for you and all that stuff, and a number to call if you wanted to join or whatever. So I guess his whole flirting thing was trying to get me to be interested in the whole no smoking thing. Which was a weird way to do it, but still, what the fuck, man. This third what the F story is something that happened just a few days ago. I had ridden my bike down to the corner store to pick myself up at what I like to call a corner store lunch. Something from the deli, which was usually a chicken strip, a slice of lemon pound cake, a bag of chips, and a soda from the soda machine. A relatively cheap lunch, but definitely something that would fill me up and satisfy my hunger, especially on a hot day. After making my purchase and getting back on my bike, which I lovingly named Minty, because she's a mint green bike, I started to ride home. It was around the time that the kids were starting to get out of school, so I kind of had to maneuver between them. And as I was coming up to the turn to go into my neighborhood, I saw an older woman pushing a cart along the sidewalk. Now, this woman didn't look like she was homeless, but she was red in the face and definitely looked irritated. So I was already slightly worried that I was about to do something to make her mad, but I mostly thought it would be one of those moments where you freeze up and actually accidentally run into a person, which oddly enough didn't happen because she moved her cart out of the way. As she did that, I was relieved, thinking that there wasn't going to be a confrontation, but as I was getting closer, I realized she was yelling at me. Now, I didn't realize this before because I usually ride with my headphones in, but as I came closer to her, I realized that what she was yelling at me was a bunch of profanities, and basically screaming at me to use the bike lane. Fun fact! The roads near my house do not, in fact, have enough room for a bike lane. So this older woman, who had no idea who I was, who I had never seen before in my life, was freaking yelling at me to use something that did not currently exist in that space at that time, and which meant that I would have to ride in the road with cars with no actual space to put my bike. Now this ticked me off. Normally, I shrink away from confrontation, and I don't like it when people yell at me. Especially strangers. And especially for no frickin' reason. But with all the time that I have my bike Minty, I have never once caused any problems for anybody else while riding her. I always avoid trying to make people move so I can ride through. If there's space, then I'll go around them. If not, I'll get off my bike and slowly walk, because I don't want to be an inconvenience to them. But this woman was just shouting a bunch of insults, saying that I was being disrespectful and yada yada rah rah blah blah. So you want to know what I did? As I was riding past her, I flipped her the bird. And then I sped the fuck up because what the fuck, I do not want to get into a confrontation with a crazy lady. And I basically sped all the way home, because I did not want to deal with this bullshit. I'm talking weird. I think I'm super drunk. But anyways, once I got home, I told my mom this story, and we kind of had a laugh. Because seriously, that was really weird and kind of funny what the fuck story. Sorry, these stories were kind of short, and I'm not completely sure whether or not they were funny, or if I described them properly, because it is currently 6:20 in the morning and I have not slept all night. So yeah, just gonna end it here. Did you guys enjoy the video? If you liked it, give that like button a boop and smash subscribe. That way you can join the Lil Monster community. And if you guys have your own WTF stories, you can leave them down in a comment below or post them on my Amino. Currently, my Amino is where I'll be posting work in progresses, some of my other art as well as some stories. And I'll also be putting up polls, that way you guys can vote on the next video. And if you guys have something you want me to see, you can post it on the Amino, or you can also use Instagram. Links to both in the description. And as I said at the start of the video, my commissions are still open, so help support the channel if you can. Oh, but before I forget, I managed to actually get a job. I know lately I've been putting the whole I've been looking for a job thing at the end of all my videos, but now I managed to finally get one. And while it's not really a job I thought I would get, I'm still happy regardless, because I'm currently going to be my little sister's caretaker. And while I won't go into detail, this does mean I'll be able to keep on working on more videos as well as helping out with bills at home. Which was definitely something I was worried about because I am terrible at time management. So I hope you guys will wish me luck and keep an eye out for new content. And with all that said, look out for the monsters under the bed and I'll see all you jelly beans in the next video. Bye!